Hello students, I'm Purnima and once again I welcome you to my class of English. Now student, today I'm going to teach you a new lesson, chapter number 9 from your book Honeydew, and the name of the lesson is The Great Stone Face. Children, in this lesson we are having two parts, part 1 and part 2. So in my previous video I have discussed the main background of the story, the summary of the story, and this story is very entertaining. You will enjoy every moment, you will be enjoying when I will be explaining you. And children, the thing is that it is having a lot of moral values. You can see when I will be explaining you, you can feel lot of moral value and a good center idea is there in this story. So I will be, before starting the first part children, I will just within 2 minutes I will just revise the important points of the lesson. So I told you children, The Great Stone Face is written by Nathaniel Hawthorne. And student, in this story, in this chapter, The Great Stone Face was formed on at one side of the mountain. Okay. At one side of the mountain, people can see the shape of a face of a human being was formed. Okay, that is stone, great stone face actually was the work of nature. Nobody has created it, nobody has carved it on the rocks of the mountain. Actually it was made by itself, it was actually the work of nature. And children, when the people used to look from far away towards those mountains, children, it appeared as if some face is there, someone human face is there, and it is looking at them. Okay, but when people used to go near them, it used to just turn into a heap of rock, nothing else but a heap of rock. Okay, now children, not only that, the people who were living in that village, they used to believe that the fertility of the village is due to the blessing of the face which was formed on the rock by the nature. So what people used to believe, that all the fertilized land and the happiness of the people is due to the blessing of that great stone face which was carved by itself on the mountain. There was a belief, and children, everybody used to love that face. Okay, now children, there were many tales were there related to that face. Now one tale was that of a mother and a child. A mother was there and her little child was also there. The name of the child was Ernest. Okay, and children, he used to sit at the door of his cottage and he used to watch that face for hours. And children, he used to wish that the face should speak to him. He used to sit on the at the door of his cottage and he used to watch that face for hours, and he really wished that the face should speak something to him. Okay, and children, not only that, children, the mother, she used to believe a prophecy when she was also a child. A prophecy was there at that time. Children, what is the meaning of prophecy? I told you in my previous video, the meaning of prophecy is forecast. Okay, so she used to believe that one day a man will come of that similar face, the face which was there on the rock, and with that similar face a person will born in their village, and he will be very gentle and kind hearted person. He will help and guide the other people in of the village. So this was a prophecy which everybody used to believe, children. Okay, and many started believing also that one day a man will surely born in the village who will be resembling the face which was there at the on the rock of the which was carved on the rocks of the mountain. Well, children, Ernest, he grew up, okay, he was a very gentle person, a very intelligent child, okay. And he, his children, when still he used to sit for hours and he used to watch that face. Now he started believing his, that face as his teacher. Whenever he used to see that face, he used to feel that that face is speaking to him, and he had a feeling that that face is his teacher, okay. And I told you, whenever he was free from his work, from his study, he used to sit for hours and he used to watch that face. Now children, Ernest could never forget the story, okay, that one day a person will born by with the similar face, and that person will belong from this village only. So he could and children, now here Ernest is growing up. He is now become adult. He is very helpful, not only to his mother but to all the villagers, okay. And children, then children, one day a person has appeared in the village, and that person name was Mr. Gather Gold. Now that person, children, he was born in that village only, but to earn money he went abroad, okay. And he settled at a distant seaport. Where he settled? At a distant seaport he settled. And what he had done, student, he started earning a lot of money, and after earning a lot of money he came back to his village, okay. Now people, all of a sudden, they started believing that this man is the same man who was supposed to have the same face. But later, children, that man, when they went close to him and when they started looking at him, then they started believing that this is not a man. Now one day that man also died, okay. Now children, years passed, years went by, and Ernest grew to be a young man. Children, he had nothing remarkable. He was very a simple hearted person, okay. But one thing was there, he was a very hard working person, and student, he was a very kind person. Whoever needs his help, he used to go and he used to help the person, okay. And but he still loved to gaze the face. Okay, he wondered why the stone faced man was taking so long in coming to their village or coming to that valley. He was still waiting that some one day a man with the same face will come to their village. Well, I told you, at first they believed Mr. Gathergold, but then he died. And now children, after some time, another son of the valley returned, okay. And he was the famous commander in the army. Now children, the people turned blindly to him, and he accepted that he is the same man whose face is resembling with the face of the with the face which was there on the rock, okay. But children, when Ernest he went near him, and he saw that there is lot of difference between the face which was there on the rock and the face which is there in front of him, the face of the commander. Well, he did not say anything, but at the same time, children, he started thinking, when the person will come of the same face, okay. He still was waiting for that person, right? So student, now I am going, this is the first part of the chapter which I have discussed with you, and now I'm going to do the explanation of this chapter. So please open your book. Okay, open your book on page number, this is chapter 9 we are doing, and page number 124 of your Honey Dew. So children, I will be reading. You will also do the silent reading with me, and we will be discussing everything, the new words, the difficult expression, lot of things to be discussed here in the lesson. At the same time, you will find that this story is very entertaining, with a lot of good messages are there in the story. Now children, you can see in the lesson also, children, see the face here, see the face of the mountain is here, okay, and you can see a face is there in the mountain. So seen from a distance, hilltops and huge rocks seems to assume various shapes. That means children, sometimes children, there are many rocks are there which takes various shape of, and that shape is of a human being. Sometimes children, they may resemble even animal's face also, but generally it is in human figure. People attribute stories to these shapes. Some stories come true, other don't. No children, many stories are true also. Okay, there are many countries in the world which are having rocks and mountains, and they are having some faces carved on their mountains, on the rocks. So the great stone face is one such shape that reminds the inhabitants of the valley of a prophecy. Now children, you have to underline inhabitant. Inhabitant means the person who lives. Okay, and children, now I will be writing some of the important one word meaning, and children, you have to note it down. Okay, so a student, you can see I have written the meaning of some difficult and new word, like inhabitants is people living there, prophecy is forecast. Okay, so these are some of the word meaning which I have written, and you also have to note it down. So children, some stories come true, others don't. The great stone face is one such shape that reminds the inhabitants of the valley of prophecy. Inhabitants, I told you, I've already written people living there. Okay, and children, valley, I hope you know mountains and valleys, right? So children, the great stone face is one that shape that reminds the inhabitants of the valley of prophecy. Prophecy is forecast. What was it? Did it come true or not? Children, there was a prophecy was there among the people from many years. That prophecy has come true or not? This we are going to read in the first part, chapter part of the lesson. So let's start the explanation now. One afternoon, when the sun was going down, a mother and her little boy sat at the door of their cottage. Now children, when there was going to be a sunset, a mother was there with her son, and children, she was sitting at the door of their cottage, talking about the great stone face. Now children, both mother and son, they were seeing the stone, the great stone face which was carved, which was there on the wall, and student, it was both were looking at him. Okay, they were talking about him only. They had only to lift their eyes and there it was. And children, whenever they were free, they only used to sit on the door of the cottage. They used to lift their eyes and they used to see that stone face. It was plain to be seen though miles away. Now children, plain area was there, and after that, after a mile, that stone face used to appear with the sunshine brightening all its feature. And children, as the brightness of the sun increases, the future of that man also, children, it also started bright, it is look very bright. That means it also increases when the sunshine used to get brighter. So here I have written the meaning of future. Future means outline. Future means, children, outline. Outline of what? Outline of the face. That means his nose, his eyes, his lips, everything was clearly visible as the sun became brighter. Now come to page number 125. And what was the great stone face? The great stone face was a work of nature. You have to underline, children, that children, great stone face was the work of the nature. Formed on the perpendicular side of a mountain by some immense rock. Formed by perpendicular. Perpendicular, children, you can write straight. Actually, perpendicular is 90 degree angle, which is straight. So, but here this is not mass. I'm teaching literature. So here perpendicular means straight, right? So the great stone face was a work of nature. That means, children, nobody had created that. Nobody had carved. Nobody had created that face. Automatically, it was framed due to nature. It was the work of nature, formed on the perpendicular side of a mountain. Formed on by the perpendicular side of a mountain. Children, what is the meaning of perpendicular? I told you, straight. By some immense rock. Immense, I have written here, children. Immense means big. Big. Okay. By some immense rock. So it was formed on the very big rock. It was formed on immense rock. If the spectator approached too near, he lost the outline of the enormous face and could see only a heap of rocks. Okay. So, if the spectator, what is the meaning of spectator? I have written here, onlooker. Spectator means actually audience or onlooker. So, who used to look at that face, the great stone face, what he used to see? Okay, he used to see, when he used to go close to him, the face used to lost somewhere, and he used to see the large rocks are there, piled one upon other. But seen from a distance, the clouds clustering about it. And children, when the people used to see from the distance, what they used to see, that one rock is upon the, when they went in near, they used to see that one rock is upon other, the clouds covering it. But from distance, they used to see clearly what? They used to see the face of that rock. The great stone face seemed positively to be alive. Now, children, what else they used to see? They used to feel, student, that the face is alive. It's not a simple, it was not a still, in the still form, it was alive. They used to feel as if it was alive. It was a belief of many people that the valley owed much of its fertility to the beaming face that was continually beaming over it. Okay, beaming means kind, children. Please write the meaning of beaming means kind. So, it was a belief of many people. Children, many people believe, okay, that the valley owned much of its fertility. That means, children, all the fertility in that valley, that means the flowers were flourishing, green fields were there, plenty of water to drink. So, all this fertility was there, okay, due to the beaming face. Beaming means kind or gentle face. That was continuously beaming over them. Children, that face they used to see, that it was continuously, that face was looking to the valley, towards the people, that face was continuously looking. Okay, so children, they were feeling, this was the faith among the people that whatever happiness and fertility is there in that village, it is due to that face, that the great stone face. A mother and her little boy, as we said earlier, sat at the door of their cottage, gazing at the great stone. Children, gazing means looking. Okay, there's a difference between see, look, gaze, glare. Okay, after this lesson, I will tell you the difference of all these words. So children, a mother and her little boy. Who was the little boy? It was Ernest. Okay, I hope you must have guessed it by now. It, who was that little boy, my dear student? It was Ernest. A mother and her little boy, as we said earlier, sat on the door of their cottage. So both mom and the child was sitting on their cottage, gazing at the great stone face and talking about it. So children, whenever they used to have time, they used to gaze towards that face. Gaze means they used to look towards the face, and children, they used to talk. Alright, they used to talk about that face, and they love to talk and see that face. They used to love to talk about that face, and they used to, children, see that face. They used to glance that face when they used to sit, when they were free at the door of their cottage. Now children, the child's name was Ernest. I told you the name of the child was Ernest. Mother, said he, while the great face smiled on him, I wish that it could speak, for it looks so very kindly that its voice must be indeed be pleasant. Now children, one day Ernest told to her mom, he was sitting, okay, he was sitting, and both mother and the child was gazing to that great stone face. Okay, and suddenly Ernest, he spoke to his mother. He said that, children, he said that he wished that the stone, that great stone face could talk, could speak. And he told ki that face is looking very kind. Okay, that feeling of kindness can be seen in his face. And children, the voice, he told, if he would be talking, the voice will be very pleasant. If I ever see a man with such a face, I should love him very much. At the same time, student, the child told that if he ever loved to see that face in his village, he would really love him very much. He would be glad to talk to him. Okay. So, if an old prophecy should come to pass. Okay. So, children, what is the meaning of prophecy? I have written here, prophecy means forecast. And in the book also it is written, a statement that tells what will happen in the future. A statement that tells what will happen in the future. Okay. So children, an old prophecy was there when the mother was child. So she is telling to her own child. Now she has she is adult and she is having her own child. So she is telling about that prophecy when she was small. She used to heard from her family members, or might be from the people of the village, or might be from her friend. Okay. So, if an old prophecy should come to pass, so she is telling that even I believe in that old prophecy, we may see a man sometime with exactly such a face as that. So children, what she told? She told a man might come. A man might come in the village with the same face. And this prophecy she had been hearing when she was a child. What prophecy do you mean, dear mother? Eagerly inquired Ernest. Please tell me about it. Now children, the child had never heard about that prophecy. He was very keen. He was very curious to know about that prophecy. So he's asking his mother. He's asking mother that, can you tell about that prophecy which you have just mentioned it just now? Even I want to know about that prophecy. So he's telling, please tell me about that prophecy. So his mother told him a story that her own mother had told her. Now children, the mother is telling a story which her own mother had told her. when she herself was younger than little Ernest. And children, when it happened, when mother was very young, more younger than Ernest, okay, then this prophecy she heard from her own mother. In fact, she told her daughter about this prophecy, that at some future day a child should be born and near here. So what she's telling, that what the mother used to tell to Ernest's mother, she used to tell that one day in the future a child will born in the same village who was destined to become the greatest and noblest person of his time. And that child will be very noble person, and he would be the greatest person, and whose face in manhood should bear an exact resemblance to the great stone face. And children, the face of that child will resemble the great stone face which was there in the mountains, which was carved by nature on the rocks of the mountain. Many still had faith in this old prophecy, but others took it to be nothing but idle talk. And many peoples were there in the village who were believing in this, who had a faith, who had a belief, who were believing in this prophecy, but many others took it as an ideal talk, or they were taking it as granted. Well, at all events, the great men of the prophecy had not yet appeared. Anyway, children, the mother and the son felt that still no other person by that face is born in their village. "Oh, mother," cried Ernest, clapping his hands above his head, "I do hope that I shall live to see him." Now, children, when Ernest heard this, he was very happy, very happy. He clapped his hand and he told, "Oh, dear mother, even I would like forward to meet him with a person who had the same face." So, he's telling, "I do hope that I shall live to see him." His mother was an affectionate and thoughtful woman. It was proper, she thought, not to discourage the fanciful hopes of her little boy. So she had said to him, "Perhaps you may." Now, children, her mother, children, even she was waiting from her child when she was young. Now she has grown up, and this story she is telling to her child. So she is, children, telling, "If I will tell this thing, he will become sad." So he told, "Definitely, child. Perhaps one day you will meet that person whose face resembles with the face which is there on the rock of the mountains." Okay. So she told, "Perhaps you may." And Ernest never forgot the story that his mother told him. Now, children, since then, Ernest never forgot the story which was told to him by his mother. And since then, he was waiting and waiting and had this faith that one day a person will come to his village and his face would resemble with the face which is there on the rock. Okay, and Ernest never forget the story that his mother told him. It was always in his mind. Whenever he looked upon the great stone face, he spent his childhood in the log cottage where he was born. So children, where his childhood was spent, and in the log cottage where he was born, children, okay. And this story was always in his mind, that one day the man will surely come to their village. Well, children, now children, Ernest is growing up and he is helping his mother very much in all her work. he was dutiful to his mother, children, whatever duty was given to him, he used to do it. And children, he was helpful to her in many things, assisting her much with his little hands. Children, assisting her much, that means with his little hand, he used to help her mother whenever she needs his help. And more with his loving heart. And children, he used to, not only he used to work hard for his mother, with lot of care, with a lot of love, he used to do whatever she gave him work, or whatever she told him to do, he used to do it. In this manner, from a happy yet often pensive child, he grew up to be a mild and quiet youth. Now children, in this manner, he was hardworking, he was very much children helping, and with lot of love in his heart, lot of kindness in his heart. Now children, that Ernest had grown into an adult person. Now he has become youth. Now he is no more a child. Now children, rest of the chapter I will be continue in my next video. So that's all for today, and with this I conclude my work. Have a nice day, student.